The boys are out today.
Should have brought my selfie stick.
My ass wants to freeze here, that's fine.
We can do that.
Hey, I'm Jeff Bacalar. I used to do the 404 podcast. That was a lot of fun. That's over. I do a different podcast now, but I'm here because it's been so long since I got to talk to you. So I came out to this park to freeze my ass off and answer some questions. Here we go. At Stephen Wallaby, what was your most surreal CES experience?
Probably going into a dispensary for the first time.
At Mikkel Winther wants to know, is there any benefit to game mode on a TV if a user already has disabled every single post-process effect in the cinema mode? I think there is. I think game mode, from what I understand, will reduce latency regardless of what you've done in the picture settings. At Fetter Dave, will I ever be able to walk into a Target or log on to Amazon and finally buy a damn SNES Classic? Yeah, you could do that right now. They're not hard to find anymore. At Brood Avenger wants to know, how do you feel about having crisps as a side dish to pizza? And what crisps do pizza do? What? What is this? Is crisps? What is crisps? Do you know what crisps are? Is that Jill?
I think I know that girl.
At 3UP asks, what dead technology bums you out the most? That's a really good question. The fact that like vinyl and CDs are just gone. I get it, like it's way better to have digital music, but there's something special about opening up a jewel case and reading the lyrics to a song and just having a connection with a band where now it's sort of just disposable. Jill, I've been putting off buying a new TV because of security concerns, like Vizio's user data stuff. Current TV is dying. What TVs would you suggest? I'm not on a huge budget. I mean, just don't give Vizio your data. I think they make really good affordable TVs. Them or TCL, if you're on a budget. Jill? No, it's not Jill. At Sweet Cries 2, do you put fries in your Frosty? I need to know. Of course, I'm not a monster. Of course I put fries in my chocolate Frosty. I used to do it all the time when I used to eat Wendy's. I don't do that anymore. At IR Gifts wants to know, what's your favorite gift? I have two. One, my buddy Drew Scanlon, the white guy who with his eyes like, huh? What? I'm sorry, what? What? And then another one's this British dude, I forget his name. He's giving this really like lame thumbs up like, okay, like that kind of thing. Love it. I try and use that all the time. Do you believe in ghosts, cryptids, or any other spooky paranormal stuff? If yes, what? And have you already had experiences? If no, what cryptid do you wish was real? What the hell is a cryptid? I don't know what a cryptid is. I don't believe in ghosts because I'm an adult man. What are your favorite 3 to 5 bands that have only one album that you actually like? That's a tough one. A lot of bands I like have more than one album I like. The one thing that comes to mind is this band called Balance and Composure. They put out one record that I really like, and everything else they've done, I'm not so much a fan. Oh, you know what? Freaking Lady Gaga. I'm sorry, I only like that one Lady Gaga record. Everything else just feels like not her. I'm gonna catch a lot of shit for that. At Cody Crumley wants to know, my mom wants a Fitbit but does not have a smartphone. Would she get any benefit from the Fitbit without having one? You know what, Cody? I'm not even sure people who have a smartphone and a Fitbit get anything out of it. At Blue Period wants to know, what's your favorite hockey movie? I am partial to Goon. I like Goon a lot. I also obviously Slapshot. And come on, am I gonna sit here and not mention Mighty Ducks? No, Mighty Ducks. At Nick Roth 1 asks, in your years covering technology, what is the biggest tech surprise to you or tech that you saw you thought would bring a big change to the world? It's not VR. That's a really tough question. This might sound kind of lame, but I think it was the iPad. I talked a lot of shit about the iPad when that thing came out, and it really has changed the way people interact with stuff. And I think it's paved the way for the large phones we have, and just the way people have kind of abandoned their laptops for the most part. What's the number one best advice you'd give to an up-and-coming dad? What does up-and-coming dad mean? I think you just mean you're gonna be a dad. You're usually like the most popular up-and-coming. Anyway, did I ask this right? What should dads do, Jeffrey? Just let it happen, man. You know, it's a wild ride. Just let it happen to you, let it wash over you, not literally because it's kind of gross, but just enjoy it because it's crazy, you're gonna laugh, you're gonna cry, and just don't freak out. Let it happen. At J-Link to the Past, is there some piece of gadgetry that hasn't been invented yet that you would think make your life easier?
Self-driving cars. I cannot wait for that to happen. I want it yesterday. I'm done driving with these maniacs on the road, staring at their phones the whole time. Robot drivers, let's do it. Let's make it happen. Where do I sign up?
All right, that's gonna wrap it up. This was a lot of fun. Thank you very much to everyone who submitted questions. Big kiss on the cheek to everybody involved. It really means a lot. If you want to ask me a question for the next one of these that we do, just leave it in the comment section below. Subscribe, hang out, tell your friends, and we'll see you next time. Peace. I can't even do the peace because my hands are so freaking cold. This is ridiculous. Let's do it, Nikki. Let's get out of here.